So one thing, we apply the algebraic way, like, for example, I operate S minus on the S in M stage. This is the algebraic way. If I write S minus and I write S is up arrow and down arrow, then this is the arrow representation. So we will check through both the representations with the algebraic case relates with the arrow representations. So this is equal to, we know this thing that this is h bar s into s plus 1 minus m minus 1, and this is inside a square root, and s and m will become m minus 1. When we will apply S minus on this. So, I can write this thing in the arrow form that when S minus will be operated S minus and I write 1 with this, then and the state is up. What is meant by the state is up? State up means that S is equal to half while M is equal to plus half. S is half, we know we are having spin half particles, while M is plus half. This is up arrow. Then I can write in this form that this is equivalent to S minus 1 and half. This is S, which is spin half. This is this orientation, or the projection of it is plus half. So put the values here. When this is half, then this will be 3 half, yes, and into 1 half. So it will become 1 over 2 into 3 over 2 here. 1 over 2, 3 over 2. Minus, this is 1 over 2, and this one, again, 1 over 2, half, minus 1, so minus 1 over 2. Right? And this is inside a square root. Here we are having h bar. Right? What will happen here? This is S, so this is half. Half minus 1, minus half. Now look here. What value you will get here? This is 3 over 4, minus minus plus 1 over 4. 1 over 4 plus 3 over 4. 4 over 4, 1. So you will get h bar here, and m will be equal to 1. And here you will get half and minus half. So what it is? H bar in this state, half and minus half, I can represent by a double arrow.
3 by 4 minus 1 by 4.
So 8 minus 1 minus is here. Minus minus become plus, right? So we have h bar, and this state I can represent with a down arrow. Down arrow means the orientation is down, minus half, while spin is half. Clear? So this is, you will have to keep in mind this representation as well. We will not do algebraic always, but this is now up to you, that you will have to keep in mind this thing, that when S minus 1 operates on this state, it converted into h bar times a down state. Clear? Similarly, you can apply S plus on down state. Because S plus on up state, you know what it will give?
Zero.
Because there are no other state possible. So S minus on a down state will give you zero. Because there are no further states to lower, to go down, it gives you zero. When S plus operates on this, it will give you H bar and it will make it up. Similarly, when S plus operates on up state, it will give you zero. Because there are no further up states available. So now what is, we have established this thing that here I will write the other one is now that when S plus operates, you write one here on this one, it gives you zero. S plus one on this state will give you H bar and it will make it. So after establishing this information, we will now act on the composite state. This was a single state. Remember, this is a single state. While this is not a single state, this is a composite state. We are having two m values here. And now we will apply the S minus on S minus on the first state that we are having, the first composite state. This one. And we will see that what's the result of this. So now I write this one in split it form. Because I know that this one is associated with one state and this one is associated with another state. This one, first one is representing the electron M and the second one is representing the nucleus M. So I can write that S minus I will decompose into 1 and 2. S minus is total. So I will decompose this into 1 and 2. 1, 2 means one state and second state. This is one state, this is second state. And now you can apply, because one will not apply on this one. One will only apply on one state. While two will be applied on this one, and one will have nothing to do with the second state. Keep in mind, these two arrows, this one is no not S, this one is not only this one. The first arrow, this is M1. The second arrow, this is M2. For this combination, when we write S in M, we are writing one only. So keep in mind this one, so that you are not getting confused with this. So what will be this one? When I apply this, we will have S minus 1 and it's operate on this, the first, while the second state is here. Clear? And plus, the first state is here and S minus is operated on this one. And this is 2. Clear? It operates on this. What this will be equal to? We will have, when S minus operates on up, we got H bar and down. So H bar and down, but down, H bar and down, and this will come as it is. Clear? Plus, we are having this state And then S minus when operates on this one, again we will get H bar in a down state. So we got H bar in down state. So this is H bar and down up plus up and down. Clear? Yes. Now here we will have to keep one thing in mind, that without normalization, we have no normalization applied here. So this is not a normalized state, but the result of the application of this. So what we got here, when you apply S minus is what? S minus is the lowering operator, and it gives another form to this one. We got another state here. When you will normalize this one, the only thing you will get here means you will multiply this with 1 over 2 here. Means H bar multiplied with 1 over 2 in this case, because 1 plus 1 square root, the normalization will come out to be 1 over square root 2. So, out of these 4 states, we got 3 states is, so out of the 4 states we got out of 4 states we got 3 states S, M, and these states are spin is equal to 1, that small s is equal to 1, which you call the spin quantum number. This is equal to 1, while m is equal 1, 0, minus 1. How? You see here that we are having a state which I call 1 state, and this is equal to up and up. 1, 1. Now this is the SM representation, this one SM representation, in which I am having spin half, and then the M orientation is 1. Like, now I am talking of the hydrogen atom. In hydrogen atom, I am having 1 spin, is you are having here 1, this one, 0 and minus 1. So out of this 0, I will now pick up 1 state. Look here, 1 and 0. So this 0 state is actually this state, which is 1 over 2, and it is up and down plus down and up. I can write it like this, up and down plus down and up. If it's addition, this order is not important here. And then 1 minus 1, and this is equal to down state. So the confusion which was here, that out of the 4 means we should have 3 configurations. We got 4 configurations. These 2 were actually confusing us, because in both M was equal to 0. And From this state, we proved that if we apply a lowering operator, because they were both up, then we got this combination, 1, 0. And another combination which is possible here, that possibility is that this was spin one state, and another possibility is that we are having spin quantum number equals, instead of 1 we are having this 0, and we are having m equal to 0. Here we are having s equal to 1 and m equal to 0. And here we are having s 0 and m 0, so this is 0, 0 state. And this state is equal, 0, 0 state, this is equal to what it will be. Look at this one. This is 1 and m is coming out to be 0. Because up and down, net spin is 0. Up and down, down and up, net spin is 0. So m is equal to 0 here. M is equal to 1 here, m is equal to minus 1 here. So what about this one? It will also be a straight normalized one. 1 will do like this, and then we can write that it will be up and down, minus, down and up.